Hello, as we got 100% votes for yes, now let's try to understand what is ant colony optimization algorithm all about. So in this video, you will learn what is this algorithm all about, how it is working step by step with an example. Topics covered in this video. First, we will start with introduction. Next is ant life cycle, how ant communicate with each other, what is this algorithm all about and how it is working. And then we will try to understand the real and artificial ant foraging behavior. And second last is ant colony optimization algorithm step by step with an example. We will try to understand step by step this algorithm, how it is working with an example. And in the end, we have limitation and advantage. Let's start with the introduction. We have 13,800 estimated ant species, and about age, queen can live up to 30 years and soldier can live up to 3 years, and they live in colonies, and an average ant colony can contain thousands of individual ants, and super ant colony contain 300 million ants. They have no ear, but they can feel vibrations through the ground, and they communicate using pheromones, sound and touch. Next is ant life cycle. Here first we have queen. We have queen eggs. If egg is fertilized, then the child is female, else male. Now next stage is larva. Here larva cannot move, so it is often fed and cared by the workers, and the type of food is used for the larva is liquid type. And the next stage is pupa. From this stage, we have a transformation into an adult ant. An adult ant can move and it can eat pieces of prey, seeds and other. Inside ant colony, we have queen, male ant and a fertilized male also known as drone that often mate with queen, and after that he die. Then we have female workers that work for the colony. And we have soldier ants. They protect the queen and the colonies, and they also attack enemy colonies for more space, and they also collect heavy food. And role of queen in the colony is, queen is the only ant in the colony that can lay eggs. You can see here inside ant colony, as inside our home we have certain rooms. So like that, in the ant colony we have storeroom, you can see the queen room, food storeroom, and like that. Here you can see the caretakers. These are the egg caretakers, and you can see here ants in the food storeroom. Next is ant communication, that is how ants communicate with each other. So first question is how ants communicate with each other. So they can communicate with each other easily using pheromones. Now what is pheromone? That is a chemical signals used by ant for the communication in the environment. And ant also deposit pheromone in case of any danger in order to alert other ant or for help. Next question is how do ants detect pheromone? You can see here antennas. These are the two antennas. So using their mobile antennas, they can detect pheromones in the environment. Next question is how do ants follow pheromones? So ant leave pheromones on the soil and it can be easily followed by other ant. That's how they follow each other. Now next is ant colony optimization algorithm. So this is a metaheuristic algorithm that is inspired by the social behavior of the real ants. And this is basically inspired by the pheromone based ant communication. And this algorithm is developed in 1922. And it is a popular optimization technique that is used to find the optimal path. This technique is also used for routing and load balancing problems. And you can see the popular problem, that is the traveling salesman problem. So this algorithm is also applied to solve this problem. And even you can also use this algorithm to solve continuous optimization problems. In the traveling salesman's problem, as we all know, we have a salesman and a number of cities, and this salesman want to visit each city exactly once, and he want to travel the minimum distance. Suppose you as a salesperson and you are in the current city, this one, And now we have a list of cities, city X, city Y, city Z, and city XYZ. Now task is here, find out the shortest route and visit each city exactly once, and after that, return to the current city. In here, in this case, distance between all cities is known. So salesman, that is you, you can calculate the distance between the cities and you can find out the shortest route. Now let's see real and foraging behavior. This algorithm is inspired by the foraging behavior of ants searching for the suitable path between their colonies and food sources. Here you can see this is the ant nest, or you can say ant colony. And here we have food source, and you can see ants are following a route. That is the shortest route. Now question is, how do ants find out the shortest path between the nest and the food? Ant can follow this one, or this one, or this one, or even this one. So question is here, how do ants find out the shortest path, that is this one, between the nest and the food? Answer is, with the help of pheromone signals, ant can easily find out the shortest path between the nest and the colony. They use pheromone for the communication with each other, that is the indirect communication between the ant using the chemical. Let's try to understand real ant foraging behavior. First, they will explore the area around their colony randomly, and here they will search for the food sources. As we all know, as ant move, it release or deposit chemical, that is a pheromone. When ants find food source, they choose the way have strong pheromone. You can see here, this is the shortest path. Maybe on this path we have strong pheromone concentration, that's why this is followed by all ants. Let's try to understand this. So we have a group of ant foraging in the environment for the food sources, and you can see they are searching for the food randomly. Now suppose a forager finds food, and now forager will mark the trail on the way using pheromone while going back to the colony. You can see the pheromone marks on the ground, that is marked by this ant on the ground so that other ant can follow it. And you can see here, pheromone marks are followed by other ants, and you can see here we have other ants surround the food source. When the food source is finished, no new mark on the bay are marked by the returning ants. Now let's try to understand artificial ant foraging behavior. So first we will try to understand this with an example. Suppose we have a boy here and we have playground, and between boy and playground we have four route, and this boy want to select the shortest path between the source and the destination. So how he can find out the shortest path? So he decided to explore one by one. So day one, while he is going to the playground, he selected this path and he noted down it took 3 minutes to reach. During return, day one, now he is going back to home, he selected second path, and you can see here it took 1 minute to reach. Now next day he selected third path, this one, and it took 2 minutes to reach. Day two, during return, while he is going back, he selected path four, and you can see total time is 4 minutes. Now he can compare the total time taken by each path and can select the best path, that is the shortest path between the source and the destination. Now day three, this person can select the shortest path, so he find out the path two, that is this one is the shortest path between the source and the destination. So we will consider this best path between the source and the destination. How ant can find out the shortest path between the nest and the food sources? That we will discuss in the upcoming slides with an example. How ants can find out the shortest path between the nest and the food source without any calculation or comparison? As we human can compare we can calculate. Now in this case, we have real ants and how they can find out the shortest path between the source and the destination that we will discuss in the upcoming slides. Now let's try to understand the artificial ant behavior. First case, all ants are in the nest and we have no pheromone mark on the ground. As you can see here, all ants are in the nest and we have no pheromone on the ground. Now, case 2, foraging start, 50% ant will take the shortest path and 50% ant will take the longest path. Case 3, here you can see ant following the shortest path arrive earlier to the food sources as compared to the ant following the longest path. Here you can see as ant move, they also deposit pheromones on the ground that can be easily followed by other. Here you can see we have ant that followed shortest path, now returning back to the colony. Now pheromone mark on the shortest path have stronger pheromone signals. As you can see here, now they are reached and they are returning. So the pheromone marks on the shorter path have stronger pheromone signals, and the probability of selecting this path by other ant increases. So next time when any ant will select any path, probability of selecting the shorter path is greater as compared to the longer path, as we have the stronger concentration of pheromone on the shortest path. In the ant, all ant will follow the shortest route as we have the stronger concentration of pheromone on the shortest path. Just imagine this is salesperson and we have a city and he want to find out the shortest route between the source and the destination. Now next is ant colony optimization algorithm, step by step with an example. Here this is the algorithm. First step is parameter initialization. Here we will initialize all the important parameter. In the second step, we will construct the solution for each ant and then we will position ant. And here we can select the next node by using the state transition rule. Each ant will select the next node by applying the state transition rule. And we will repeat until ant will the best solution and then we will compute the fitness value. After that, we will update the best solution and apply the offline pheromone updates. And in the end, we will display the best solution. First step is parameter initialization. Here we will initialize all the important parameters like the population size, that is the total number of artificial ants. Here we have 20 spores. And next is max number of iterations and the pheromone initial value. As we have no pheromone in reality, so we are using here artificial pheromones value. Then we have pheromone exponential weight, pheromone heuristic weight, and we have pheromone evaporation rate. Second step is ant solution construction. Here we will start the loop 1 to max number of iteration, that is 200 spores. Now next step is position each ant in the starting node. Here k is the ant, that is the number of ant. So kth ant move from node I to node j. This is node I and this is node j and this is k, with the probability that is this one. Here for any ant k, this is the probability of moving from node I to node j, and this is the total pheromone deposit by the ant on the path ij. And this is the value of the path ij. Now we have 4 ant spores, that is the population size, and this is the source, and here we have destination. So how to find out the shortest route? So now we have 4 ant, and you can see 4 routes. Now they selected their route and moving. As they move, they deposit pheromones on the ground. You can see here, this one reached first, that is the best solution. Now we will update the best solution. We will compare the best solution with the each ant solution, and if any ant solution is less than best solution, we will consider that ant as the best solution. this is optimization algorithm, so we will consider the minimum value as best value. In this case, you can see here we have the best solution, that is this one. Second best is this one. Third best is this one. And worst solution is this one. Now next step is we will apply the pheromone update. Here we are using the artificial pheromones. So pheromone trials are updated when all ant completed their cost. First we will compute the solution for the each ant, and after that we will check best and the worst solution. And for the best solution we will increase the level of pheromones, and for the worst solution we will decrease the level of pheromone trial. Using this equation we can update the pheromones for the each ant. Here this is the total pheromone deposited by ant on path ij. This is the pheromone evaporation coefficient, that is the total number of ants, and here we have total pheromone deposited by kth ant on the path ij. And here you can see this one, that is path length and constant. Here you can see this ant is returning earlier as compared to other. So you can see here pheromone level is increased when we have the best solution. For best solution, we will increase the pheromone. We have, as we are using the artificial pheromones, so we will increase the pheromone level for the best solution and we will decrease the pheromone level for the worst solution. Here you can see this ant is back to the colony with food, and you can see the other ant on the bay. Now next time when any other ant will move out from the colony for the food searching, the probability of selecting this path is higher as we have higher concentration of pheromone on this path. Pheromones evaporate in the ground after some time, so probability of pheromone evaporation in the longest path is higher as compared to the shortest path. We can see here among all we have this path. On this path we have the stronger pheromone concentration, so in the end all ant will follow this route. In this algorithm, first we will compute all the values for the ant, for this one, this one, this one, and this one, and after that we will select the minimum value, that is the optimum value. So in this algorithm, first we will compute the pheromone for each ant, and after that we will consider the best and the worst solution, and we will repeat the loop until we have the maximum number of iteration, and after that we will display the best solution, that is the optimal solution, or you can say the optimal path that cover minimum distance between the source and destination. Now we have limitation and advantage. The limitation is this algorithm uses more parameters, and an advantage is when you will use fewer number of iteration it provides better solution. And you can see here we have a traveling salesman. He wants to visit each city exactly once. And task is here, find out the shortest route, visit each city exactly once, and return to the current city. That we will discuss in the other video. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.